we are going to study about the uses of dihydrogen. Dihydrogen, that's a hydrogen gas, has lots of uses in industries. Okay, so what are the uses of dihydrogen? We'll discuss in short, in brief only we'll discuss. Okay, because in the chemical properties of dihydrogen, in the previous video, we had discussed about almost all the chemical properties which are necessary. And there itself I explained many of the uses of hydrogen, like hydrogenation of vegetable oil to get vegetable ghee, like that. Many other reactions also we have studied. Okay, so let's see what are the uses of dihydrogen gas. First use of dihydrogen is to synthesis of ammonia. Ammonia synthesis using Haber process. So first use of dihydrogen is Haber process. Haber process, important, we had studied before itself. So what was the reaction? We'll write in short. N2 plus 3H2 plus 3H2 gas gives 2NH3. This was your Haber process under 673 Kelvin, 200 atmosphere. 673 Kelvin, 200 atmosphere, and spongy iron. Spongy iron is used as a catalyst. This reaction is known as Haber process to prepare ammonia. We know this, right? Okay, so this was one of the use of hydrogen gas. Without hydrogen gas, this is not possible. So hydrogen gas is important for that. Okay, we'll write. The second use of dihydrogen gas is for hydrogenation of vegetable oil to vegetable ghee. Hydrogenation is one process. Then third is reduction of element from its oxide. To obtain element from oxide, you can react with hydrogen gas. So reduction process. We have studied about reduction of palladium. 2 plus ion to palladium. That process, like that, you can use hydrogen gas to reduce. So reduction process. Reduction in metallurgy. Metallurgy means it's a scientific principles which regarding extraction of metals from their ore profitably. Okay. So, reduction process in metallurgy, we can use hydrogen gas. Then fourth use of hydrogen gas is to launch space vehicles like rockets. We can launch the rockets using hydrogen gas because hydrogen gas is highly inflammable. So, rocket launching, fuel for what? Rockets. And many other spacecrafts like that. Fifth use of dihydrogen is, it is used in hydrogen economy. Hydrogen economy, we know. Hydrogen economy simply means storing of hydrogen safely. So we'll see what is that use. Okay. Oxyhydrogen torch is important. Fifth, this is very important. Oxyhydrogen torch. This is very important. Oxyhydrogen torch. What is oxyhydrogen torch? That is, hydrogen can be broken down into individual HH atoms in welding. Welding, you know. Welding, you have seen welding process, right? Where they are using a particular kind of holding substance through which they shoot flames, right, onto a metal target so that it can be melted. So use that process that actually happens. The chemical process that actually happens is hydrogen gas is actually present, which is released from the flame nozzle. Hydrogen gas is splitting into individual hydrogen atoms. Hydrogen atoms are formed by giving heat energy. We are burning that hydrogen gas to form. So we are actually heating it. So, hydrogen atoms are actually formed. So, that heats the metal also, right? That is, the metal bar will be kept and we are heating by applying gas flames to this metal. At the same time, through the gas flame, hydrogen gas is also passed. So, that also gains enough energy and splits into hydrogen atom. But these hydrogen atoms are highly unstable. They quickly come back to form hydrogen gas. That is, this hydrogen atom again react to form hydrogen gas. H2 with releasing of tremendous amount of energy. So, energy is released. So imagine 1000 joule of energy is released by the flame. Imagine, okay, or maybe 10,000 we take. 10,000 joule of energy is released by the flame itself, and some of it is used for hydrogen breaking also, breaking the bond. Then on releasing energy, it also sometimes releases 10,000 joules of energy. So how much amount of energy is actually used for melting the metal? 10,000 plus 10,000. So total 20,000 joule of energy the metal is getting. You only need to supply 10,000 joule and the metal gets 20,000 joule of energy. So that much the increase in energy is present when you use oxyhydrogen torch. Oxyhydrogen torch is because this takes place in presence of oxygen. Oxygen is needed for burning. That is why, okay? So hydrogen and hydrogen combined to form hydrogen gas with the release of energy. This energy plus the energy of the flame melts a metal very easily. This is how welding process takes place, okay? This is the concept regarding oxyhydrogen torch. Okay, that's easy, I think. Then, it's used in fuel cell. Sixth uses, it's used in fuel cell. Hydrogen gas can be used to generate electricity. How? Because, how? I will explain. Okay. Fuel. It's used as fuel. Fuel to generate electricity. Hydrogen gas can be burned. Hydrogen gas can be burned in presence of oxygen gas. Small amount of heat you or spark you supply, then it forms water. This reaction is spontaneous and exothermic. This is exothermic means plus energy. This energy can be converted into electricity. This process is known as hydrogen can be used to produce electricity. Okay, so this is the reaction. This explosive reaction, that explosive energy is converted into electricity through generators and many other types of things. Okay, so this is the use of hydrogen. So many uses we have discussed. So all of these uses are very important. And we know that hydrogen gas is also important in life processes also, because hydrogen element is present in your body. So like that, many things we know. So this is all about hydrogen gas. Okay, hydrogen gas uses. Now we will be talking about hydride, metallic hydrides, different types of hydrides we will be discussing in the upcoming video. Please make sure that you watch it also to get better understanding of this chapter. Thank you. And please do like, share and subscribe. That would be a great help to us. Thank you.